Here we see the action of the return idler. It is adjusted from the inside of the engine compartment and it is built onto an eccentric shaft, like a crank. Here we can see one complete track section. It is 5.2 meters long, consists of 80 track pads and track guides. Let's take a closer look at the track link and see how it is put together. In this view, we can see the track section and how it joins together. You notice what it is, it's just a rory butt hinge. Fit it into the hair, like so, with a bolt that acts as our linchpin. That is pushed right through with a nylon core nut that screws on the other side. The actual butt blade here fits onto one of the track pads, which has been rebated, so allowing the same height from this one through to here, and is secured in firmly. This will now take all the load right through the conveyor belt or through the track. You can see the individual track pads. First part we have is the main core. This is made from jarrah or any hardwood, which I have turned out on a jig that turns out the ends for a 19 millimeter diameter, right there, with a poly tube ring fitted over to that. This prevents the timber from splitting and wearing away against the drive sprocket. Onto the main core, the pad, we have our shoe. This has been cut from 19 millimeter form ply. It's quite tough and is cheap. That then bolts through from this side. Here we have a joining plate, which is similar for those that carpenters use for joining roof trusses and joists. That is then hammered straight down onto the pad. This will protect, will take all the wear. Here you can see the track guides. They bolt through with a single bolt right through, and there is a pan head screw fitted to there that prevents the tooth from actually turning. Keeps it in line with the track. On the outside of the track and in between each track pad, there is a metal strip that has been riveted through to the conveyor belt. This is to prevent any sharp objects piercing the belt and cutting the belt. Now, the conveyor belt is very tough stuff, but if sharp objects get into there, it can cut through and you'll break the track. These little bits are made from hoop iron, 1-inch galvanized hoop iron. You buy it by the strip, cut it to the length you need, and fit it in. The beaut thing about using conveyor belt rubber is that apart from it being reinforced, it doesn't stretch. That means that if the tank, or when the tank is turning or slewing, there is no lateral twist to the track. As you can see, it takes a fair bit, and with the weight of the tank onto the track, it will not twist, which could cause you to shed a track. Simple, extremely robust track system. In fact, this would be tough enough to pull a diesel locomotive. But I hear you say, crikey, this is a lot of work to go just for the tracks. Okay, it's going to take you a long time to do it. It could take you 2-3 weeks to make up a section of track. But you can take comfort in the fact is that this fella will give you years of reliable service. Right, here we see the drive sprocket. Notice how the tracks mesh with it neatly. This way you can be ensured of actually getting the correct pitch. Well, you must get the correct pitch for the track pads and the sprocket teeth to align. As you can see, fairly simple arrangement. We've got something similar to a bobbin or a cotton reel design, which is steel pipe and steel flanges welded. The actual face of the sprocket, or the sprocket wheel, has been machined on a jig out of a high density PVC, 12 millimeters thick, and surprisingly very strong, because all the force is in this direction. They're easy made up, and once you've got a jig or a pattern to go by, you can route one of these things out in a few minutes. It mounts onto the final drive shaft with a stud plate, which has three studs in it, which lock in and prevent the shaft from freewheeling inside the drive sprocket. You will notice on the bogies, which are forward and at the rear of the tank, the outside set, that is the most forward and the most rear set of wheels, the height is set. This is to provide more stability for the tank. At the rear of the tank, you can see the track return idler wheel here, and a towing bracket mounted through into the hull and reinforced. This enables the tank to be towed or winched onto a trailer. Again, you can see the box formation of the plywood, 12 millimeters thick, and underneath the entire tank, all the way right through to the front, is a 1 millimeter thick sheet steel that protects the driver in case you go over something that would pierce the bottom of the tank. Let's have a look at the engine.